What's Up Fool podcast with Rodrigo Torres.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
What's up,
Felipe Esparza right here, man.
Hell yeah.
The mic. All right, man. Shout out. Midnight sent me a message about how he is living in the Philippines right now, and he gets homesick. So he listens to the podcast. He plays it so his daughter can hear and learn English. So now she says, "What's up, fool?" all the time. Damn. Cool. Savage Chief, thanks for iTunes review. Sorry about your getting dumped, dog. But hey, man, it happened to the best of us, eh? At least you came out and admitted it, bro. We're still waiting for Hillary to come out. Upcoming shows. This weekend, November 10th through the 13th, at Addison Improv in Addison, Texas. November 19th at Horseshoe Casino in Hammond, Chicago. No. November 19th at Horseshoe Casino in Hammond, Indiana. It's in the Chicago area with Paul Rodriguez. Órale. Hey. December 10th, one night only in Sacramento at Harlow's Nightclub. January, I'm coming to the Bay. I'm coming to Pleasanton, California. Los Angeles and Atlanta, Georgia, as well as Miami. January, I'm coming to Pleasanton, California, Los Angeles, and Atlanta, Georgia, as well as Miami on Mike's Epps Tour. Check all the dates and info at philippesworld.com/tour. That's funny, man. I was thinking about, you know, wow. We have a new president, people. President-elect Donald Trump. I don't know his middle name yet.
Jay, right?
Jay.
Donald J. Trump.
Jay Trump. And I remember I was talking to Lisa when Bush won. Remember Richard Cheese?
Yeah, in the morning.
No, Richard Cheese. That's Rick Dees.
Oh, okay.
Richard Cheese.
No, I don't.
He had those funny songs about he'll change
the NWA one and all that.
No, he'll have funny songs like lounge music.
Yeah, you had that CD, right?
Yeah, Richard Cheese. He'll sing that song about.
Didn't it have Boys in the Hood?
Boys in the Hood.
That's what I was saying by NWA. Easy.
And but it was all lounge music,
right?
And that's funny. He was not a big guy, but he went on tour only in places where Bush didn't win.
Oh, that's
the little counties. And his tour was, if you voted for Bush, you get no dick. But there were other. He only went to the little blue states
that were taken by Al Gore, right?
Should, yeah, man. What's up, fool? Don't forget, people. We have an Amazon little window on our philippesworld.com webpage, and you can check out anything you want to buy, man. You can buy hats. You can buy all your Christmas shopping through our Amazon page. Also, check us out on the Church of What's Happening with Joey Coco Diaz.
Hell yeah.
And Lee Syatt and Rodrigo Torres was there, and we almost got kicked out of their new studio. Anyways, they're going to get kicked out anyway, so we were just there to say goodbye.
That shit was cool.
Yeah, Joe Diaz was older, huh?
I was talking to that fool like 2 hours after it, dude. Well, he didn't stop talking, dog. Let me tell you something, Silent Bump.
I know, man. He had the age where he could tell a story, huh?
Oh, fuck. We got to put a little Santa costume on him, bro. You know what I'm saying?
So you had Benny Mena on Yemen?
Yeah, we had Benny Mena. That episode's up. Flacco's will be up tomorrow morning.
That fool talks.
Who?
You talk a lot in your show?
Benny Mena? Yeah, dude, he let a lot of stuff out, dog.
He does a lot in person, too, man. Remember, I said that if Benny Mena would write a script, he'll give the extra lines.
It was funny, dog. Yeah, it was cool. He talks a lot, man.
So what's up, fool? We were in Parlor Bar last week.
Bellevue, Washington?
In Bellevue, Washington, man. Man, it was crazy out there, man. We were like, Rodrigo was like rolling up a blunt at this Starbucks patio. And then this creepy-ass white dude was standing behind us. He was like the creepy version or the white version of Rodrigo.
He wasn't creepy. He was shifty, dog.
Shifty.
Like, this fool had like a little trick under his sleeve, dog.
He was smiling too much, man. Like,
yeah, and weird eyes.
The kind of smile that if you're smiling like that at a barbershop you've never been to, you're going to get punched.
Something's going to happen, dog. But you alluded to the shit like, oh, well, just tell him the story because you mentioned on the church a little bit, but I didn't give enough justice.
Oh, we were just standing there, man, and Rodrigo rolling up that blunt and Toby Hayes standing there, you know.
Looking like a blunt wrap.
Looking like a blunt wrap. Fucking cold as hell. Finger were freezing.
Frozen fingers, dog.
Just for fucking finger were frozen at 70 degrees outside.
I was like, damn, that brother got cold, dog.
Yeah, man, he got cold fast. He was sleeping. He put his room was at 80 degrees, bro.
Yeah, dude, I was like, dude, I went in there. He's all, yeah, man, it's cold. I was like, cold? God, what, do you got the fireplace on?
I thought you were from Omaha.
I know, dog, damn. But I was trying to roll the blunt all, like, you know, incognito style, you know what I mean? You know, right there on the little table, people walking by, little families. And that fool kept on walking by, like, kind of looking.
He kept walking by.
Lingering, over, dog.
Lingering, man.
That's the word, dude.
And then I just walked up to him, man, to see what's up, you know? Check him out. Like, I stand next to him.
What's up, man?
And I told him, what's up, man? And he goes, oh, man, nothing, man. I'm just here trying to sell this machete. This fool had a big-ass machete in his bag.
Yeah,
about to slaughter us.
Yeah, it was like a shopping bag. And then you told it, because like, yeah, I'm waiting for a guy from Craigslist, man. I've had it up there for a couple weeks.
He probably thought it was us, bro.
That's funny.
Fucking machete jack his ass.
Yeah, because he said, he's all, oh, don't even worry about that. I'm just over here trying to sell this machete right here. I was like, because he had it in like a shopping bag. He looked like a dad, fool, like a coach, like a softball coach or
sweats.
Something. Yeah, and the, you know that coach jacket and those, like... Well, I mean, one thing you said about me is wearing those, like, you know, those small little socks, ankle socks, dog. But, and then we left because we rolled it up and we're going to go roll. And they're all right, dog, so you can go ahead and kill everybody. We're going to leave now. And that fool started laughing.
He started
crazy.
Laughing, bro, like he was going to really kill these people.
Like a maniac going, oh, they caught on to what I was doing.
He goes, no problem. I live on the corner.
Yeah, I just live across the street.
So what are you telling me, man? I ain't no cop.
Yeah, well, who cares, dog? You're doing something badder, dog.
I know, Stella Machete.
Worser, dog.
That was a nice leather one, too.
Yeah, like, I didn't peek in there, but you're all, damn, dog. What did you tell him? You gave him that Game of Thrones reference?
Yeah.
This fool, dog.
This fool's selling a big-ass machete, dog.
But he looked like he was going to narc on us, though, huh, fool? Like, at first, because I was like, oh, dude, this fool walked around 3 or 4 times, dog, back and forth, dog. He walked in Starbucks. He didn't buy shit. Like, it was, so he was up to something. Then we, you know, figured it out. He's probably selling something in the black market internet or whatever? Yeah. The dark internet.
I gotta Google machete killings in Park and Seattle.
In Bellevue. Hey, but that's crazy because didn't they? They had a shooting there like a year ago, right in Bellevue, but at the other mall, not that one. Shit's getting crazy, dog.
Seattle's crazy, huh?
Oh yeah. Oh, dude. Like, and that's the other thing too. Like, where we've been going lately, where Salt Lake and then like Seattle. There's a lot of bums there, huh, fool? Like in both those little clean little cities.
I know there's two men over here now. They moved over there under the underpass on by the 2 freeway by Eagle Rock.
Oh, right here in L.A.?
Yeah, L.A. No, Eagle Rock, California.
Okay. Eagle.
The 2 freeway, underpass.
Okay, yeah. But where?
Next to a park.
Okay.
By the Chevron right before you get to Colorado.
And that's what they're doing, dude, because they're displacing them and shit, and then they're just going to other spots. Where are they going to go, fool? They don't have a home, dog.
Elysian Park.
There you go, dog. And you've been, but what I've been noticing, or I mean, thinking we're noticing, we talked to the dude when we got to Salt Lake that one day, the driver, MJ, is a lot of those fools are hypes, fool, right?
In Salt Lake City, they look like heroin addicts.
What do you think's up in Bellevue or Seattle or Washington area?
Same, bro.
Yeah.
They're younger, though, in Seattle.
Yeah, because
they're like probably like rich kids, bro, who left or who just mad at their moms. So they're going to go party and don't do no more drugs in my house.
Yeah, because you can tell when, you know, fools are white and stuff, but they were like pale and skinny, dog, and, you know, little rings around their little eyes.
Yeah, man, they were in a good one.
Yeah, or looking for one, you know, a little scratchiness and shit.
So this will be in Dallas, bro. Hopefully we'll see some more homeless people on our homeless people tour. But there's some places here in Los Angeles that, of course, Skid Row area, like, downtown Maple, that area, San Julian Street, it's always going to be homeless people. But, man, over here, closer to Silver Lake, like the end of Silver Lake and like the end of Echo Park, before you start hitting what? I will say that it's mid-city of Los Angeles area by the end of Silver Lake, by that restaurant that Willie used to go to.
dude, Barragans?
No, the restaurant. Oh, no, that's Sunset.
Okay.
Over there on Temple Street.
On Temple.
Yeah, he used to go to a little bar right next to a Taco Michoacan. I don't know the name of it.
Damn, dude, I'm coming up short on that one.
It's though. On over there by Benton Way and Beverly.
By Rampart?
And Beverly.
Okay, was that considered mid-city right there?
Yeah. They used to have salsa music there. His friend owned it.
Oh, the Mexican... No.
Mexican Village.
Oh, that's okay. All right. The little buffer zone between like Hollywood and Silver Lake and all that.
Yeah, that area, man, if you make a right by under the bridge, there's this one dead street where there's like some industrial... Man, it's a lot of homeless, bro.
By Virgil, fool?
Yes.
That's what I was... Because that's what I was trying to paint, dog, or get in my mind what you were talking about.
Yeah, but that area is deep, huh?
Yeah, well, when I was coming back from the podcast last week, I went by there and I was a fucking deep as hell, fool.
They live all...
Litter, dog.
They live all on the freeway, too.
And they already had their little houses made out and everything, huh? Like, they clean their little spot.
They have bicycles.
Yeah, dude.
They have fixies.
It's funny, though, dude. It's, like, weird. It's, like, they have a home.
Then you got the homeless people in Hollywood. Those fools have 8x10s, bro. They have personalities.
Trying to break in the business, you know?
They come up with character, like, in downtown, bro. There used to be a guy called a pirate. That fool was called a pirate. He was homeless. His name was Ricky the Pirate. Hit a fake patch, and that fool had like a pirate hat, and just walk around going, arrrr.
I was wondering, trying to leech on you, go, hey man, let me give me an addition to Superstore.
He was going, arrrr.
You're lying, fool.
Yeah, man.
That's crazy.
He had 8x10s, bro. Like, if you don't want to have no chain here, man, take one of my photos, man. I'm trying to make it in Hollywood.
Way to network, dog. To the people.
And it's, some people would paint him, and like, some artists would take photographs of him.
Uh-huh.
And I remember he was showing me the photos, dog. Like, this hipster white dude, I guess, you know, he probably was from the Midwest or down or somewhere far, bro.
Idaho.
Somewhere far, bro. Where he would everything that he's doing here in California, he could have done it in his town.
But it's not
like,
interesting.
Yeah, taking photos. He could have hung out in his homeless town in St. Louis or
he didn't have to come to LA.
Indiana. Homeless people in Boston. He could have done all that shit over there without coming to California. So he's taking photos of Ricky the Pirate, right? And they're all just regular photos you could take anywhere of a homeless black dude, but except this one had a pirate hat. So he's taking photos. He showed me the photos. Then he takes. He showed me photos that the guy's not gonna print. He's not full hitting a rock.
That's an interesting one.
That's
huh?
The one you should put, man. Fuck trying to be artsy with this guy trying to be a pirate. Show what he really is, a fucking homeless crackhead.
Yeah,
a
bum, dog.
Because the other photos look like he's enjoying that shit, bro.
He's all distinguished, huh?
Like, and he was showing it to me, bro. And at the time, I was trying to stay off drugs, but off and on, I was still doing them. And when he showed me the one that was him smoking, I could hear that crack sizzle, dog.
Oh, this fool, dog.
It was like...
It's a process, you know? This one's taking a little hit.
And then you lose a tooth.
Clink. Yeah, man. It's no help.
It was part of my crazier times, man. When I was living at the loft, I was living with another comedian. And it's weird because, like, I kept getting work and that fool kept getting no work. So then if I come home, it'd be like coming home to a sad-ass wife that can't get a job. Eh?
But why would he be depressed, though? I mean, it's like,
it's
hey, dog.
Sad, I guess.
Fuck, do some push-ups, dog.
That's what I've been doing, bro. Push-ups every day.
Yeah, dude. I mean, I slipped this weekend because I was sick, dude. But, dude, I'm
still
on
good
that.
When I'm sick, but I got to fight the cold.
Dude, man, I was feeling like shit the whole week. Had the runs, dog. Ugh. Sorry.
This fool told me that at the fucking green room, I have the runs. My butt had a rash. And I'm like, standing there getting ready for myself. I said, what can I do, bro? I'm over here. I got two hands, bro. One in nachos, one in water.
I'm sorry, dog, to put you in that predicament, bro. But it's like, dude, I was
Toby Hicks eating slow, bro.
Oh my god,
he eats as slow as Gabriel.
He eats like a fat fool.
Those fools enjoying a hamburger, bro, but eating like it's like a fucking filet mignon.
Yeah, I thought he was gonna start cutting up the bread and shit, dude. And he didn't finish his food, huh, fool?
He didn't save it for later, right?
No, dude. That fool walked out and he's like, man, y'all eat a lot. We're not even eating a lot, dog.
Fool, I thought the wind was going to take that food, dog. Who's heavier, him or Flaco?
Ah, that's a good one, dog. Probably him. Nah, dude, it's probably a tie because you can hang those fools up in the closet, dog, if you really wanted to. If they're being bad, tie them up.
The black old man, when he was fucking had the migraine and I was touching his neck, I think that fool had a weak-ass neck, bro. I could puncture that shit.
Oh, fool, I thought I was going to bust that shit when I was fucking hit because he tells you to pinch it, right? Dude, I did both hands, dog. I was like, dude, fool, I'm not going to do
the
this.
The whole time, now when
kill this fool,
now
dog.
When I'm fucking hanging out with slippers and I'm pinning her back, I'm thinking, motherfucker, I was petting a big-ass rabbit.
Yeah.
Flaco.
She has the same little neck. Shout out to slippers. Yeah, dude.
Yeah, bro, because slippers have that rabbit little bones in the
back.
Yeah,
that little
like,
her little vertebrae.
Sega storage neck. And Flaco had the same thing during migraines.
It expands. It gets big, dude. I guess what pressures his little spinal cord.
Opium's a motherfucker, huh?
It's a hell of a drug.
Your body been locking.
Well, dude, and it gets that little release. It's like,
That's something that I never done that, but that's something that's also you get addicted to in time, huh? Like the first time they gave it to you. You think doctors knowing, a doctor doesn't check if a patient is addicted to drugs or he's a crackhead before he gives them drugs, right?
No. Opium. Unless there's like a history, you know what I mean? Or, you know what I mean? And but he has a condition that warrants that little fucking injection. You know what I mean? So it's kind of not odd. So he doesn't maybe see ulterior motives if there is any.
His heart was made by DuPont.
Yeah, dude. What was it? Like he has an artificial ticker or something?
That fool walking the fucking Grim Reaper, bro.
We should have gave that fool from us Bellevue to give him that machete, dog.
That fool just dressed up like the Kiss of Death. For real, he should be the Grim Reaper every day for Halloween, bro. He's gonna find a small-ass little scalpel.
Yeah, I don't know. What's that shit called that they used to cut stuff with? Isn't that the cut basher back in the day?
I don't even know, bro. That funny man, they expect Mexicans to know farm equipment. I don't know none of that shit, dog.
Yeah, I don't even know.
I know what a rake is and a lawnmower and a leaf blower.
A shovel.
Only because of the memes.
Yeah, I don't know what the name of that tool is. A tiller.
See, we have to have farm girl over here, eh? From the Midwest, corn husker over here. A tiller. I would have never guessed tiller, bro.
Yeah, nah. But then again, it goes, here, I'm going to go till the land.
Because I remember when I was in rehab, we used that to cut side grass like this.
Yeah, to like knock it down, all the pasture or whatever, or high weeds.
Because I was in rehab, I was in Live Again Recovery Homes. Anybody looking for a place to recover, go to Live Again Recovery Homes. And you don't really need money to go there. They'll take it out of your unemployment check or disability. So at that place, man, I guess the whole time we were there, they were trying to give us stuff to do to take our mind off drugs.
Like chores and stuff?
Chores, yeah. So activities. every day we had little meetings to go to. But then we had like stuff that we had to do. Like we had to go clear out a fucking fire brush or fire trails that are made of mountains and sagas.
Fire breaks.
Fire breaks.
That way you guys don't have that way the fire can stop and not jump over to that.
Yeah, or the fireman can get to it through there by running without breaking brush.
Oh, totally.
So we were there, man, fixing the trail because it was all covered up over the years.
Yeah.
So we did that like up the mountain, down the mountain, bro. And then we did this guy's house.
Straight up,
man,
labor work, huh?
Stupid ass fools that we were. Like none of us wore t-shirts. We were out there like slaves, bro. Even the slaves wore shirts, bro.
Getting baked?
Baked.
By the sun, I bet. And out there, dude? Oh, my God.
We were
God.
Baked, bro, and we were hungry, dog.
Oh, my. That makes you super hungry and dehydrated.
And then we were mad when we got there, bro. We had to wait till 5 to eat. We've been working since the morning.
Are you serious?
Then they have good-ass food, dog.
What, they have slop?
No, it was bad. I remember it was bad that we went to our last meeting at church, the whole pastor's speech and church and recital was about food, complaining about food.
It got that bad? All right, for example, what was a plate? What was a dinner plate that you guys had that night?
I don't remember, man. You don't remember? It wasn't good enough to remember, though.
Oh, my God. Like goulash and shit? Or like
not goulash.
Bologna, mashed potatoes.
It was like probably
Salisbury steak.
It was probably something bad, like a bunch of beans. No, a bunch of potatoes. And a bunch of vegetables in a can mixed with ground beef, and that's it.
Are you serious? Dog food, dog. It's like, fucking, that's fucking, oh. But you know what? If you're hungry, you're going to eat that shit, though, dog.
No seconds, dog.
No, dog. You must have been starving over there.
They give him rose with no butter, dog.
Oh, Hey, because, all right, dude, when I first met you, remember we went with Vinny El Catrin to your mom's house? Like, I mean, I think the way you guys grew up eating is kind of like, you know, you bring a lot of stuff together. There's rice, beans, and there's some leftover meat. You put it together, and there's a lot of food for everybody. Yeah. So that's what you're used to. And then you go over there. No seconds, dog.
I remember Vinny was all happy, bro.
Oh, because we can eat, dog.
Shit, we're at my mom's house. We haven't been in a long-ass time. So my mom brought out, my mom treated us like Joe Pesci's mom when they finished killing that fool in Goodfellas.
Yeah, she'll find an avocado. She'll cut it up. There'll be ceviche there'll be fish.
There was salsa. And then my mom said, get a pescado. And she fed up this old-ass fish.
Yeah, but it's good, though, dog. And that's like the stuff that you keep around because it's like you don't waste the food, right?
Yeah, because it was like during like Passover. So my mom, we have a lot of kids in my family, right? So
it seemed like everybody was over.
My mom thought that everybody was going to be there. So they had a barbecue, leftover barbecue, and I didn't go because I was at a show probably. So Rodrigo and I and Vinny went to my mom's house, and man, she said, ¿Tienen hambre? Vinny knows how to say yes in 9 languages when somebody says they're hungry.
Just with his eyes, dog.
He just showed with his blue eyes. See more, please. That food. So my mom made, we had leftover carne asada, but then my mom brought out this fish that they barbecued. But then my mom added more flour to it and second deep fried.
Yeah, they refried it.
That shit was crunchy. Yeah. And even the, man, let me tell you, people.
Perfect.
I'm vegan now, but I can explain good fish. You know how sometimes when you buy a fried fish and you open it up and it has a lot of scale? Well, man, my mom fried through that motherfucker. So it was an easy peel, right?
Yeah. But it's like, I don't know how to say it. Like, she tenderized it where it wasn't like, it's not going to be hard. You know what I mean? It's all edible, dog. You know what I mean? But that's technique, fool, from years of cooking.
I was surprised, bro. I bet my brother would have showed up there and said, we never eat like that.
But it was cool because there was like lemonade, there was Kool-Aid, there was soda from 2 liters. It was bomb, dog. Tortillas got brought back to life, dog.
Cool. There were flour tortillas. There was a lot of beans, a lot of rice. A lot of everything.
Yeah, dog. Potato salad, too, a little bucket of it, dude. It was tight, dog. Yeah.
Is my dad there? No, huh?
Nah, fool.
Fuck that fool. He wasn't there.
But it was funny because it was, I don't know, your mom started cooking, and then other people started coming, like your brother and the kids and your sister. And that's when that one time you guys, your sister told us that story about your sister was funny one day at like Thanksgiving or something. And she made a joke of like, they gave you guys rolls or something, you guys at somebody's house. And then she's like, how are we going to like make these warm or something? And she put them over a candle or some shit.
Yeah.
And making everybody laugh.
I died, bro. That's when I busted out that joke about, what did I say that, I had that joke about black people in South Africa or Ethiopian joke. Oh yeah, I adopted one of those African kids, you know, for $10 a month. I made the payment. That fool sent me the collections. Anyway, so when I said that joke at that house, I didn't know that all the young men that were there, that were 14 years old, were orphans, bro.
Damn.
And they were doing most of the fucking servicing of.
Oh,
they were like the house slaves of the house.
Really, dog?
So would you like another spoon? Stuff like that.
Really?
They were their slaves, dog. They were all just, they were thugs. They were cholos, bro. 14, 30 years old, 15, but they were serving us, bro.
Really, dude? That's trippy, huh?
You know, like, because you know the lady's getting a check for these dudes. She's planning on spending on them.
Well, just like, dude.
She got free, when you adopt a kid nowadays, like those guys from, not just them too, but for little example, the guy from that who just got acquitted, the guy from Las Vegas, the one that were in the ranch.
Were the guys that did that standoff?
Yeah. Okay. What were the names?
Bro, I don't remember, dude. But it wasn't the Bundy Ranch.
The Bundy Ranch people. One of the guys that was arrested, he has like 7 or adopted kids, and those 7 kids, they work for him on the farm for free.
Well, yeah.
And he gets government check from the government for having orphans in his house.
Triple dipping, dog.
Triple dipping, bro. Free labor.
And free pasture, dog. That's free what they were fighting over. But it's funny, though. I think I was
but
telling
not, you. They're not the only part. Ones that do that, though. Everybody does that.
That's just one example.
They're just one little example. They're getting away with it at a bigger scale, but There's people in the hood who do that.
Well, I noticed, dude.
Latino moms, white moms, black moms.
From the people I've noticed, and I'm not dogging on
anybody. They never get treated good, right?
No, but it was mostly like, you know, Chicana moms. They would get a couple foster kids during the holidays, fool, to buy gifts, dog.
Orale.
And then they'll shake them loose in January, dog. But I think it's like once you adopt them, you don't get that. You don't get that money from the government or whatever, state or local, wherever it comes from. You know, and then you become your kids. But then that's probably why the dude at the Bundy Ranch has those fools working out there tilling the land.
It's the Bundy Ranch, not the Bundy Ranch. Bundy Ranch is a whorehouse.
Yeah, Bundy.
Let's get back to the Bundy Ranch, bro.
I've never been there, dog.
Oh, man. Anyways, people, like, I know, like, the last time we were talking to, alone together, we were talking about Tag Your Sponsor.
Yeah, that one.
And, man, it got crazy last week.
What happened, fool?
Man, remember... They exposed this girl again. Remember I told you the little blondie, because she they asked her, would you have sex with a 12-year-old?
Damn.
Over here in Dubai, and then a lot of the women say, hell no, man, it's against the law in my country. You know, I don't obey the laws. It's plus morally wrong. But some didn't care, bro.
Because they're gonna divergentize them, right?
So then the guys were pissed off. Hey man, how come they don't get arrested for being pedophiles?
Because they're women, dude.
You think it should be the same law?
Yeah, dude.
If she's ugly, huh?
It's well, based on looks.
No, really based on looks. Like, most of the guys who pedophile are fat, ugly.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes, you know. But it's funny when they show those teachers that are kind of hot. You're like, dude, what the fuck? And then they have them all chained up. You know what I mean? All like she's going to run away and did the crime of the century. But
I know, man.
I think it's good that they get prosecuted because it's just different, though, because we don't look at women that way in our society, I think. Or I believe, I would say. What do you think?
When you were a kid, that you were like, did you have a teacher that used to, yeah, she's hot, man.
Yeah, dude. Well, but not really, dude. It's not until I got in high school, there was one, the art teacher. But I usually had like, you know, ladies that looked like Barbara Bush and stuff. But they were always cool. But I mean, nothing like, I wouldn't want to sleep with them or nothing like that.
I know, man. All my teachers were old, bro.
Oh, dude, I had teacher teachers.
These fucking teachers been teachers in the 60s.
Yeah. They were around since Kennedy got shot.
I had Miss Reynolds, Miss Flannoy, Miss Waite.
Yeah.
Only one teacher was hot, but I didn't have her, Miss Mataleones.
Damn, was she Italian?
Miss Mataleones, blonde lady, bro. She looked like Cindy from Three's Company.
Damn, you got a good one over there.
Yeah, man. But all my, you know, but all the kids were lying, dog.
What are they saying, dude?
Oh, it's funny, man. Lies, bro. Like, lies. Little kids. Like, I was watching an episode. Or I downloaded some of our gang, Little Rascals.
Oh, hell yeah. They're awesome, dude.
And I forgot how hot Miss Crabtree was.
Yeah, dude.
For her time.
Yeah, dude.
And so the kids have a crush on Miss Crabtree, and they're all lying, dog. And I remember my friends, now I know my friends in school were lying. My brother had Miss Mataleone. She was blonde, bro. I told you she was beautiful, sexy lady. And, man... And look at all the photos of all the little kids. They're hugging her like their girlfriend, bro.
Yeah, looking at her.
Yeah, man, they're hugging her. And I remember my brother would tell me, yeah, bro, she likes massages.
That fool's already giving like little neck massages.
Yeah, she likes when I massage her neck during the movies. Creepy ass little fool, right?
Hey, but did he really ever massage her? No, huh?
I don't know. Imagine, bro, you're a teacher there. This creepy ass, little ass, cold ass squirrel hands come behind you. And like, it's first grade, bro.
And I know, like, back then they probably didn't have those laws, but now they have laws where you can't really, like, you can't be touching students or in any of that fashion, dude. But this fool said she likes massages when they watch movies, dog. Was he at the Cinestar or something?
You know how pissed off people are right now at this election, man? Win or lose? They're pissed off, bro, like when we were kids. And I was a kid, bro, man. Old school, man. It's how old school it was. We used to watch movies. And the teacher used to bring the VCR and the television and he used to wheel that motherfucker in.
Yeah, in a little cart.
And the VCR was huge, bro.
Yeah, dog. OG VCR.
If you stole VCRs back then, man, you were stealing one at a time.
Had to have a good back.
A good back of that shit was heavy.
Strong back.
And we used to fight over who's going to be light monitor.
Oh, yeah, dude. That's funny. It brought me back.
Think about it, bro. If you didn't get choose... or chose it to turn off the lights during a movie, you were fucking pissed, bro. And that's how people feel in this election. They didn't get to turn the light off.
Yeah. How about that fool that's just plotting to do it the next time? I'm going to get it next time, dog.
I was always that dick, bro, that they'll choose that person, but then I'll stand by the door and I'll turn it off myself.
I'll be like, fuck that. I already
some fool did that to me, dog. He fucking turned him off. I went back over there, turned him back on, waited, and then turned it off.
Yo no me dejo.
Yo no me dejo, güey.
This fool. But I was going to ask you, so what happened with the tag of the sponsor? What's up this week? Or what went down last week? Oh, that 12-year-old thing.
Oh, yeah, man. She says I can't do it. Uh-huh. It's morally wrong, one of the chicks said.
Okay.
But they still put her page up, you know. I don't know. I don't know why they're exposing these chicks. Now I'm thinking about it.
Why do you think they're doing that shit?
I don't know, because they don't have $10,000 to go on a date with them, or $1,000, whatever it is.
What they get paid? Yeah, that's kind of like reverse hating, maybe.
But they're really exposing is women who get bad butt jobs, bro.
That too.
Some of the butts they have, these chicks have like wow, like. God knows those tiny legs can't hold that up.
It doesn't look like.
Yeah, you don't have the stretch marks to match that. Like, if you have a butt that big, your back should be looking like a Bengal tiger, bro. I mean, your back and the bottom of your legs, your thighs should be stretched, bro. Like,
she had legs like Serena Williams.
Stretch, bro. Like somebody like wants to rip you apart. But then, cause for real, man, because some of them are just too big.
Yeah, I can't sustain that.
Then you watch, oh, man, also one of the laws that passed was the no condom laws in porn no more.
Also, so that passed?
Yeah, so the porn star don't got to wear condoms during the porn no. I like that law because, you know what, that putting on a condom during a porn was cutting back on my masturbation time, bro. I was losing my heart on, bro. For real, like he's like grabbing her, going down on her. Then they have to go put on a condom, bro. I was losing my heart on. People were creeping up behind me at Starbucks. I really didn't have time to really enjoy the movie, bro.
Lock the door, dog.
For real, bro. I'm in the bathroom taking a shit now.
I don't, dude. They're doing it, dude. It's more natural, dude. Why do you have to wear a condom? Seriously, they're actors or whatever. And then some people with the argument, well, what if you ever get with the porn star chick and then you're using a condom and she gives you something? And I would never be with the porn star chick, dog.
No, actually, bro, I'm kind of concerned about that now. You know, about I would like the porn star to wear a condom because later on, I don't want this porn star to give me a venereal disease when I hook up with her on Backpage, bro.
What kind of venereal disease?
Because you know, you told me to be on Backpage, bro.
No, like the porn stars, the ones that fell off, that ain't as popular as they used to be, they'll be on that one, Backpage. And there was another one that the government shut down. I want to say it's Red Space or Red Tube. Not Red Tube, but they shut it down. And right now, the person that just won the senatorship or Attorney General, Kamala Harris, was going after Backpage. Those fools are all in litigation right now, in court and shit.
Speaking of business, bro.
What's up, dog?
How many? Now, you know, because we know how you and I, we've been to a lot of places. Mm-hmm. We know how people make money. Right. We know people fly out hoes. You know what I mean?
That's a fucking show right there.
Yes.
Fly out hoes.
I was just thinking about how many escorts and prostitutes were at the Republican National Convention.
There has to be a lot, fool. Because the same time when the Super Bowl and the World Series, all that shit, all those big events and hotels are littered with them.
We might see them on the plane when we're flying out tomorrow.
Dude, we've seen a couple women on planes that were dressed really provocatively and showing a lot of stuff like they didn't care. And you can tell that they got their shit paid for. Again, there are assumptions, but I think...
When I see a hot chick like that on a plane sitting next to me, I know that chick's on the way home.
Oh, yeah, with loose sweats or something.
Because on the way there, she was first class.
Should have got her on coach.
For real,
on the flyback.
That's how you lure them, bro. You know, how much is it? $5,000 for a whole week or $10,000 a week? I'm okay, baby. I'll fly you out first class. Because if you fly them out first class, they know you're serious.
No, you're right. Dude, that makes those a girls good
always,
point.
Always post the first class ticket. But on the way home, bro, they're sitting next to me, bro. I'm the one that posted that selfie next to you. Psych!
She's all disgruntled. No, that makes a lot of sense. They never get you on the return trip.
And not to just say that all women do it.
No.
There's gay men doing it too, bro. There's a lot of little men out there too, bro, prostituting.
Bunch of little twinks.
Showing up a little red hat, bro.
Make this butt great again.
For real, man.
Nah, dude, of course.
There's money to be made everywhere.
Oh, yeah, dude.
One thing that this relationship is going to do is make money for a lot of people that want to make money.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. It's just a little conduit for it.
You're going to know the right people.
Oh, hell yeah.
Pay your taxes. Don't be like, oh, I'm not going to pay my taxes because Trump did not. I'm going to get your ass.
Yeah, you ain't Trump, dog.
You're not Trump, bro. You're not smart.
You don't have that privilege, fool, of growing up madly rich.
For a lot of sad faces, bro.
Yeah, for a lot of Jordan meme faces.
A lot of Jordan memes.
But you know what, Felipe? I was thinking, you know, like people are pissed off. They're like, are you pissed off? What am I pissed off about?
I'm not, because California, you didn't win California. Yeah. We're still good.
Yeah, and on top of that, it's just a democratic process. Look at it, like when Obama won, how many people were pissed? Look at it 8 years later, how many people are pissed? It's just push and pull, 49% against a 51, give or take a little, whatever, dog. Just a process, dude, you know, whatever.
We have a listener who's happy. Mark Bell, shout out.
He's all happy the Trump won? Hey, man, good for you, bro.
Good for you, bro.
Yeah, because there's one of you. Not just playing.
You think he's going to be in a be held accountable for all those things he promised he was going to do?
Well, this is what's going to happen.
It's day one, bro. We still have the wall.
Right.
But there is a wall already, bro. But El Paso's huge.
Yeah, fool, but it's only sectioned. It's not complete, but they do it for a reason. Because if they do build a real, real wall, what are these Border Patrol agents going to do? They're going to play chess.
Play handball.
There you go.
Play rebote.
But and you're going back, like, what he's going to do real quick, though, Felipe? You know, look at Obama, dog. Like, I mean, all the promises he promised, this and that. And, like, the...
And Bush, too. No, yeah, new taxes.
That whistleblower law. I mean, what's he going to do? Is he going to pardon Snowden now? It's like, come on. They're going after him. It's like, come on. They ain't going to... It's really not going to change, dude. It's just more, like, rabble-rousing on social media, and everybody's giving their opinion now. They're, like, political experts. It's hilarious, fool. It's, like, almost like preaching, dog. Everybody's preaching the sad whistle, fool.
Man, when Donald Trump said his acceptance speech, because I wanted to see it, right? I wanted to hear it. You know, new president. I want to see what it's about. And he said the right things that America wanted to hear. Not his supporters, but what America wanted to hear. And I could still hear the cheer. We're not as cheerful, bro, when he was talking. There were every time we mentioned America, they got excited, but he didn't mention what they thought that Trump gonna come out and be hateful. Their supporters.
How his character
is
being up to
him. Yeah, man. They thought he was gonna come out and go like, yeah, we won. Yeah, man. And start pointing fingers. But no, man, that fool went up there. He did his job, bro.
Little call for unity.
Man, those red hats were sad, dog.
They're all like, because it's the thing is, like, once you get up there, and that's the thing. And
it's different than when you're up there, huh?
Yeah, and this is the difference with government, right? With you got a Democrat, you got a Republican. All right, whatever. You guys have your ideals, your policies, your fucking your little feathers in your hat that you follow. But once you get in government, that's what it becomes. Government. It's always gonna be pushing, pulling, dog. It's like a dickhead at work that wants to do more than you want to do less. Let's bind together. How are we gonna do it? You're never gonna do it, and you just do it. You know what I mean?
Man, sad. He gonna have no time to take no bong ribs, bro.
Look at hair, dog. The hair is what's just funny. But hey, dude. You gotta respect it, dog. Like you said, you know what I mean? You didn't, you know, weren't going for him, but you wanted to hear what he said, and he said the right things, like what you should say now when you're in that position. You know what I mean? The thing that, like, what's really gonna happen? I don't think we're gonna have a drastic change. I think more people are adding to the fire that doesn't really exist, fool. What do you think, fool?
I think people are infrastructure, bro. We gotta build these bridges.
Well, see, that's an enormous point, cause what
in Detroit, bro? Speaking of bridges, Al Madrigal, who was on the Daily News, he was doing a funny bit about it over there, because there's a bridge that needs fixing, the one that goes from the border of Detroit to Canada.
Okay.
Canada said, hey, we'll fix it. We'll do it. No charge to you guys. We'll do it. Detroit voted no.
why would you think that they vote no, though, Felipe?
Why? Because they're going to, I don't know why.
They don't want no money to leave Detroit.
I turned the channel when they said no, but they were asking them all, and they were all saying hell no, you know. But they were all like, it was weird. Like, somebody offered to fix your bridge. That's infrastructure. You got voted no on it.
And I think it's more of the thing that they're like, their pride. We're going. We're America. Why would you get cheap Canada to do something? We'll do it for ourselves. That's an insult. You know what I mean? Maybe that's why. Or also too, they're just like, come on, it's just a little bridge from Detroit to, you know, over there in the Canuck land.
For the Canadian consulate, immigration shut down yesterday. Yeah. Fools calling in trying to get information.
Yeah, I heard that shit took a little spill, dog. Too many fools trying to hit up on it. Hey, dog, come on, fool.
Get out of here.
You really think fools are going to move to Canada, dog?
Hell no.
You think anybody's going to live this place?
I think more Canadians are going to move over here. Like Russell Peters.
It's like, come on. Even though we have a lot of traffic and all this shit, pollution, nobody's moving anywhere, dog.
Nobody's moving.
Come on, what, the dude from Breaking Bad said he's going to move? There's a good, what's like, Katy Perry's supposed to move? All these, like...
I can't wait for them to leave, though.
Isn't she still struggling to buy that piece of property off Los Feliz, that where they have all the nuns at or whatever, that little sanctuary?
Like, who else said they were gonna move? The Cher, right?
I don't know, but there's we can look it up real fast if you want on your phone. But there's a handful of them. They're more than 25, you know.
Man, but you know what? George Lopez said who to move.
Bro. Yeah. It's funny. I was going to bring that. I didn't want to be all like, you know, master of.
You have a little sitcom in Toronto.
I'm all alone. Home Alone-y.
Man, but you know what was scary, bro? During when Trump was accepting his speech, mm-hmm. his speech was, you know, it sent the message out there, unity for everybody, you know, even embrace the people who were voting for her. You know, don't look at them, you know, like they're bad. But, oh man, his cabinet looks scary, bro.
Oh my God, blowhard.
You see all the dysfunctional crew, bro.
Oh my God,
he has fucking
Giuliani.
Giuliani, bro.
Pence, right? Well, that's his VP. Who else?
Bro, did you see that shake that fool gave him?
Like, oh my
get God, your ass over here.
Oh, that was like it revived him, huh, fool? Like, dude, it gave him like it was like a Viagra shake or something.
Yeah, and then he shook his hand, bro, like that dude in that like, shakes that hand in Portlandia, bro. With a leather jacket. Lance.
Yeah, that was just shining right now, huh?
No, when he shake Pence's hand, bro, it felt like, look alive, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Your boring-ass speech.
Oh, dude, come on. He's a bland dude. He's like, you know, you give him an M16 or a tank, he'll blow shit apart, but he's not a good dude to communicate, I think.
Man, CNN were...
In that fashion.
CNN were reporting in tears, bro.
Well, it was funny. To me, it was funny, like, people actually crying.
Yeah, man. Blitzer was talking to bro like you never say nothing bad, bro.
Oh, dude, it's funny how they're like how I could say their candor changed like throughout the election. I seen the numbers when the numbers were going more towards him. You can see everybody like their little faces, dude. It was funny.
For when he was walking up to accept the presidency, they were still saying, "Well, he not really had won yet." All the way through the way he was walking, bro, they still would not accept it.
Hey, dude, what are you gonna do? You're not the string puller over here.
Yes, let me see the list of people who are moving to Canada. Here we go, people. Other way. People are gonna move to Canada. Here we go.
Future Canadians. Eh?
John Stewart is moving to Canada.
See you later, mate.
Chelsea Handler is moving to Canada.
These aren't all Canada. Some people said.
Nev Campbell.
Beirut. Nev Campbell.
Diller.
Haven't heard that name in a while.
Lena Dunham. Take your show with you, eh?
Hasta la vista.
Keegan Michael Key.
What was that?
Amy Schumer said Spain. Keegan meet Michael Key. He ain't going, man. We need him in Saturday Night Live. Chloe Savini.
We seen her at the airport one time, dog.
Chloe Savini. All right.
Adios.
Al Sharpton, he ain't going to Canada, dog.
Come on, fool. You can't shake down politicians in Canada.
Yeah, man. Now,
or interest groups.
Now his price of his speeches just went up.
Ponytail, brother. Who else?
Natasha Lyonne from Orange the New Black.
Yeah, that's not our girl, Stacey Dash, though, huh?
No, she's the one from Slums of Beverly Hills.
Oh, okay. I thought I was like, maybe she could have done that. Because I just said, I heard Orange is the New Black. No, you don't leave.
Eddie Griffin, bro.
Oh,
Eddie Griffin.
Man, brother, I thought I just seen you at, when you
where he would move. He said Africa.
That brother gonna rob his ass out there, dog. Who else, fool?
Spike Lee. Yeah, you took a loud ass movie with you, bro. It's loud ass movies, bro.
Oh,
I got two syllables for Spike Lee. Madea.
He'd be hating on that comedy right now, huh, fool?
Amber Rose, bro.
Hey, I can't wait. The
who
bald-headed
model.
Ass.
Where would she move? Unspecified.
To other side, the other side of the lot.
Samuel Jackson, bro.
Really, fool?
Yeah. He would move to South Africa.
Did I?
Cher, I was right. Cher is going to move.
Really?
Yeah.
Back to Armenia?
She's going to move to Jupiter, bro. So she probably didn't mean
do
what
you
she said.
Believe?
It. George Lopez is going to move to Mexico, bro.
Fuck.
Barbara Streisand, Australia or Canada? Raven Simone, bro.
Later.
Whoopi Goldberg. I already thought she was from another planet anyway, so I'm putting her back to her planet.
What planet?
Omari Hardik.
Who's that fool?
All right, man. This guy's gonna. Bro, if you leave, nobody's gonna know that you left, dog. So just stay, right?
You needed a credit, dog.
Miley Cyrus.
All right. Take your dad, too.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
She's
Who? Supreme Court Justice.
Yeah, she's a
She's going to move to New Zealand, bro. To the more. Amy Schumer's going to move, bro.
Where's it? To Spain? Ya vete, la chingada, no gastes otro tiempo más.
Hasta la vista, por favor.
Adiós.
Katie Hopkins, British columnist.
Fuck, never heard of her.
Where's she going to move? America. I think that's it, bro.
It's funny little list, huh? They ain't going to move, dog. Oh, my God. That's funny, dude. What's up?
We're all sad, huh?
Yeah. Fool. I mean, what
are you surprised? Where were you at when you found out?
Oh, I was, me and Vinny went to go eat at Norm's last night. But I got home at about 12. But we were at Norm's. I was just checking my phone. But I was just surprised. What do people really expect is going to happen to their lives? I mean, unless you don't have papers or something. And like, do you think he's really going to start deporting illegal, undocumented? Undocumented immigrants.
It costs money to do those things.
You know what I mean? What are they gonna do? They want you to go register yourself, and that way you can pay your $2,000 federal fee to, you know, start your legal process. But really, times 12 million, $2,000 times 12 million people, dude.
That's a lot of money, huh?
He ain't gonna do it, dog. I mean, are they really gonna build that wall complete, fool? There's tunnels now, fool. There's little. I mean, come on, dude.
How about all the wildlife habitat in that area, bro? You build a wall.
Those are other issues, the environmental issues.
And those mountain lions, whatever they are, cougars, all those little animals.
You have to preserve that
stuff.
Those
people are used to going through Mexico to get water and going, leaving Mexico and come back to the United States to get water. And you cut that off, where the fuck is it going to go? Well, yeah. You know, they started dying in some of these places.
Yeah, you mess up the little ecosystem. And those are
it takes them a while to realize that there's a wall is there.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Those are other issues that are important, too, if you want to continue building or stacking that wall. And if they really wanted to build it, you don't think they would have built it already? Their demand for cheap labor is so enormous that it really doesn't make any sense, fool. And that's the funny thing, though. It's like, dude, Mexico has a little wall against Guatemala, dude. Like they have a pretty big wall and like well guarded one, and that's funny because, you know what I mean, this one's like but it's for reasons.
I thought to get into Mexico through Guatemala, you just gotta go through that river.
Well,
that
no,
water.
It used to be easier, but it's not as easy.
I started a movie.
It's
one.
Harder. It's that one movie that we had with that one train.
Yeah,
that was a crazy ass movie. But no, it's not as easy as it was before. Just like it wasn't. It's not as easy as it was before to come through.
Because Mexico does have an immigration problem too,
oh,
right?
Yeah, they're
a big one.
Their immigration is called migra. That's what they do, and that's what they do. They cattle up people and then kick them. They beat them up and then throw them back.
At least over here, you don't get beat up.
Yeah, they'll treat you civilly, dude. I mean, come
they
on.
Take your money away too, right?
I think if they if you have like over a certain amount of money, but
they
What's that cheese called that they mix that stuff with?
Chorro. No, it's what's it called?
Ayote or what?
Ayote
or something. The cheese, the little stuff that's in, they mix in the cheese to make the pupusa.
Nudo. El nido.
They mix in the cheese? Yeah.
No, when they make the cheese for the pupusa, the whole mixture, what is that called?
Because there's like a little herb. Because when me and Hussein jacked that cheese from that restaurant, so lo loco or what? I forget.
Loco, yeah.
It will, lo
loco.
But that's the name of the slaw.
Yeah,
that's it.
Oh, yeah, but no, they mix a little herb in the cheese.
Achayote.
Cause that stuff, all the cheese that we got had that in it, and we're making quesadillas of it, and we finally got tired. Like, yeah, man, we're looking at fucking too many. Is that oregano? Like, it's a weird.
That's the third part of tamales.
Oh, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
Epazote.
There we go. That's what it is.
Epazote is a little herb they put in pupusas.
It's a tea, really.
Okay.
Yeah, and Rodrigo and them, they stole the
two bags of cheese, like two 5-pound bags of cheese.
Like the cheese you mix the masa in to make the pupusas.
You put in the middle.
Yeah, after a while you get sick of it.
Oh, we got sick of it. And then Hussein took it to he took the other bag in that half bag to go hunting, to hunter leg it up there. They shoot pigs. And like, I guess those fools got tired of it too. Fuck, we just started throwing it to the squirrels, eh? And they got tired of it, eh? Well, 10 pounds of cheese, dude.
I remember at that
over a weekend. That's too much.
At the Christmas party, he got all embarrassed.
Because you
when
brought
I walked
it
up,
up
to him
fool.
And goes, hey, what's up with that cheese, dog?
He's like, what's up, man? Because Mondo doesn't know about this stuff, well, you know, if he's listening. But, I mean, it's all, we took it because it had roaches on it. It was infested.
Hey, man, when Mondo goes...
It did. Well, that was our excuse. Because we're paranoid. Because he's all, what the fuck? What are we going to do for this? They got, I'm all, Hussein, they got cameras, fool. I was thinking that shit too. You think they're turned on? I'm all, come on. You know they're turned on, fool. And dude, that fool sitting there thinking, dog. We're driving, dog. It's all, I got it. We're just going to say it had roaches in it, eh? That the cheese was infested. It was sealed in bags. But they never said anything, dude.
And Mando, wherever he works, whether it's a bakery, he has never turned down coffee and bread, huh?
Nah, fool. But let me tell you something about Mondo, dog. People love Mondo.
Of course.
Women love Mondo. I'm telling you, dude. And I don't want to put... And this, Mondo doesn't do stuff bad, but I'm going to tell you how good of a person Mondo... He just is... His, I don't know. Just his little aura that he has, the way he is. Real cool. You know, just always just fucking... Just,
a little joke, quick joke?
Yeah, dog, but just nice, though.
Without touching you?
Nothing. Dude, just cool. And, you know, a little smile, a little mustache, a little fucking... Dude, the psychiatrist lady that we're doing a work for, a rat, she was like, you know, she... Dude, I went there 2 days after he already started the project, but she had his tea ready, his little bread, his little banana bread, like, oh, yeah, man, this... And then she was all pulling me aside.
He's married.
Pop, like when women try to be nice to Mondo after shows and Pops is there. Oh yeah, just wondering if you're right. No wondering. He's married to my mother, Gloria. All right, Pops, we're just talking. Eh? We're not trying to run away. You know what I mean? But people like Mondo. People love him. Like everybody loves Raymond. I think everybody loves Mondo, dog. You know what I mean?
They give him
like
burritos that. And shit.
Oh, they make food for him, little sandwiches. They put, I brought Rod because he's going to fix with all. Oh, I'll make a sandwich for Rod too. Oh, see, I told you, man, they're going to be good. You know, but it's just how he carries himself, dude. Really fucking cool, dog. There's mad love for him.
They give him a lot. So he never says no, huh?
Oh,
no,
fool.
He's a professor for the palace, huh?
But there's been a couple, fool. There's been a couple times where we do these places that they sell pupusas. One's in Burbank, one's in Van Nuys. And we do clean outs where they have a lot of roaches. It's just like, they just don't clean. They're in the walls. It's really wet and like...
Wet's bad, huh, for
it
roaches?
It is, because it's food for them. They don't need food. All they need is muck and water to survive. And every roach capsule has about 50 roaches. Those will be 50 apiece. From those roaches. So we're just gassing the hell out of them, dude, hitting it with Actisol, dude, three types of chemical, and then just like littered a bunch of dead ones, right? And then they'll be all, le vamos a dar unas pupusas vos para llevar. Oh, okay, vamos. And I mean, I'm not, because Mondo doesn't turn down food, but he's all, I don't know about these, right? I'm like, you see all those fucking roaches that came out of there? He's all, we'll go somewhere else, eh? We'll give them to a bum or something, eh? And he wouldn't throw it away. He's all, hey, man, can you call? Hey, man, you like Salvadorian food? Anything will help, man. Thank you, man. Like,
fool, you gotta watch Larry the Cable Guy, City Inspector, dog.
You see, that's another movie you told me is funny as hell. I still gotta
I know it's cheesy, man.
No, but if it's funny, it's funny.
Cheesy, but Larry the Cable Guy, Food Inspector, bro, he's like, he's investigating all these restaurants for roaches, dog. Some of them are cool, bro. He walks in there, they give him food. He slacks off. He don't write him off, bro. But that one place, that guy's a dick, bro, with everybody.
Uh-huh.
He's treating the waitress like shit, the customer like shit. The place is dirty. Man, it's like that fool knows where they're hiding without even seeing them, bro.
Yeah,
this fool goes, he just goes like this. Hey, man, what you got here? Some invitation? Where are you at? And that fool just goes... And then fuckers, they all run now, bro. Roaches, rats, bats.
This boy said bat. That's funny. And
if you know your job as an inspector, you can make money, huh?
All right. And this is what I heard from a guy that owns a lot of property. And I'm not. This is not my opinion, but that a lot of those fools are corrupt. You give them a little something, they won't write it all the way up. It's LA's huge. It's a huge county, so you know stuff can go on. But I'm not bagging. I'm not saying anything on him. But it could happen, dog.
But if you know what, looking for roaches, you're looking for infestation. You know the rat, huh?
Exactly. You can go back behind the machines, motors. Where
well, Larry Kimber got hit his foot on that panel because he was sitting at a bar restaurant with the bottom was wood, so it had the little flaps, the little slab right there.
The little baseboard.
Baseboard, bro. It was a weak baseboard. He just tapped that dude and everything came out.
That's the spot where they hide. And I noticed it. You notice in a restaurant where they have that piece of metal, that stainless steel, to protect the wall. Well, every night they spray it down with hot water, right? So that baseboard is getting wet, and underneath that wood's getting soaked, and it's getting rotten, and they're getting in there living and breeding and all that stuff. So when those are the spots we hit. And even the lady at that one place in Burbank, I said, no, well, se meten ahí abajo en tal hueco. And then they, you know, they're in there. So you hit them with the Actisol, that little fine dust spray, or dust, and then they just start coming out and coming out. And you have to look. That's why you got to get your
like
little...
Like that movie 300?
Hell yeah, fool. They don't even stop. They got little axes, machetes, dude, little gas masks, fool, taking a shower, dog.
Little red trim hats.
Yeah, fool. But they just come out in loads, dude. But you have to go in there with your little flashlight. You gotta get it down on your knees if you're gonna be a good pest man. You just have to. And you know, cause like we'll send a couple other guys in there. No, it was all right, man. Fucking, you know. And like sometimes I would work with you saying, go in there, spray the hell out of them, let's get the hell out of here, Rod.
But those people don't know that just by you going there one time, they're gonna just fucking disappear and never come back. How you gonna keep going once a month?
You have to treat it.
Keep being clean.
Yeah, a lot of people think that we're just gonna hit them with poison and your problem's done. No,
no.
There's eggs there.
You gotta service this.
There's ones that the chemical didn't get to, and they're gonna keep on coming out. And you leave food.
The roaches that went out of town for the day. They were fucking spending vacation in the bathroom.
He went to Santa Cruz for the weekend. You know.
When I see a roach in the bathroom, I know this motherfucker lost. He left the trail. Ain't nobody eating no food in here. There ain't no water.
And let me tell you.
They come out of the shower, huh? The
it's big water, motherfuckers. Fool. Let me tell you, dude. And with the ants, they send drones out to look for food and look for water. Yeah. So you live, exactly. You leave stuff out, they're going to get to you. You just have to maintain a clean house. That's it. The most you can. Or
remember Freddie Soda had that joke? He goes, when my dad kills roaches, he just leaves them there on the ground.
Yeah, I remember he's all, and he goes, so the other ones know goes,
why,
happened.
Why, dog? He'll clean it up. Because the other roaches could know what happened, eh?
Yeah, dog. R.I.P. Freddy Soto, dog.
Yeah, man. They come out, like, I noticed, like, right now, winter, they're trying to hide in your house.
Because they cold.
Yeah. But in the winter, in the summertime, they're gone, bro.
Oh, my God. They're out. They're hot. They're sweating or panting,
they're
whatever.
They're having sex with cats outside.
A horny-ass water bug, dog.
But during winter, because a lot of people have heaters on. Man, let me tell you, dog. When I was living in the projects, I remember every winter we turned the heater on and it smelled like cockroaches, dog.
Why?
They were sizzling, dog.
You straight fried those fools when you fired that little furnace up, dog. That's what happened.
They didn't give a motherfucker a chance to run.
Hell no. And you see, you know what that smells like. I can, like, if I go in your house, all right, and you have roaches and you have a problem, I can smell if you have roaches without you burning the furnace or anything.
No, people don't even know, huh?
Hell no.
Well, you should have seen, dog. I remember I would just open up the heater and I wouldn't hear smell the motherfucker sizzling. But you know the motherfuckers are running.
Oh, hell.
Because sometimes they would just come out of places you didn't think roaches were going to come out of. The light bulb.
Yes, fool. They love heat, dog. Who doesn't love heat when you're cold? They're not warm blooded.
Toby Hicks. He's like a little critter, bro.
He looks like a little critter, dog. A long critter, fool.
Lisa told me.
What, fool?
We're talking about on the fucking... an enchilada. She used to live above a fucking bar.
Yeah, she...
Below the bar.
That one rat story.
So the rats were all dying from the pan of Rico here and go, wee, wee, wee.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, all right, they didn't do it properly. They didn't close off the holes. They didn't set traps.
You're an expert here.
Yeah, man. Hey, dude, field rep. I was certified by the state of California Structural Pest Control Board. I've been on the thing to do up the field rep question, so I know a lot of what I'm talking about. It's just not jibber jabber, but anyways, so they didn't do it properly. They just threw poison at them to kill them and stop them from running in. If you don't close off those holes, they're just gonna keep on coming in. On top of that, you kill a big ass rat and they'll slowly die, but you with big old organs and shit, smell, the stench that's gonna come out of those walls or that ceiling is gonna be disgusting, fool.
Then the rats will eat that motherfucker. Huh?
Oh, dude, they're cannibals, dude. You know what I mean? And then they a lot of that stuff before it used to have secondary effects, it doesn't now. Dude, they get immune to that shit. Like they'll nibble on poison, go, they ain't gonna do nothing to me. They won't even eat it. Like they'll spit it out. Like they know what's up, dude. Rats are fucking smart, dude.
I remember our Christmas tree, bro, being eaten by roaches, dog. I'm making that up.
Oh, I was like going, dude. Oh, I'll tell you one thing that I seen and this wasn't in the projects. This is over there in the jungle. If you take La Brea all the way to the back, but dude, I seen and this sucked. I mean, these are like 14 immigrants living inside a one bedroom apartment that they subdivide them themselves with little 2x4s and little fucking wood paneling. There was a baby. This place was so infested, dog. The baby's eyelashes got eaten by roaches, dude. That's how gross and sad it can get, dog. And what are you gonna do, dog? It's disgusting, fool.
Put some chakra in her eyes. That Chinese chalk, bro.
Make the silver lining, dog.
Make a little chalk eyeliner with a roach thing.
The little face. Or give a little roach chalk mask.
Before I remember when I was living at the small house with Lisa, I was sleeping, bro. I found a roach on my arm, bro. I fucking slept standing up.
Oh, let me tell you, dude. If you don't like roaches, you don't fucking like them. You're never going to get used to them. Never. They're fucking gross, and they've been inside me when I'm spraying. They get in there and fucking move around, and I fucking just get gross the fuck out and take 7 showers.
A fucking roach got in my fucking ear, dog.
Yeah, we had to cradle them like a baby.
A fucking roach got in my fucking ear, dog. Fucking Willie held me in a blanket the whole night, dog.
I thought you was a thug. You just showed the little bullet, dog? Dick.
Fucking roach were coming out of my fucking La Puente leather jacket, dog.
La Puente roach, boy.
Fucking studs.
You're killing people. But yeah, man, it's fucking crazy out there with insects and rodents and all types of pests.
People, they can fuck up your house, roaches. Yeah.
Dude, it can get bad. It can get super bad where you're going to have to yank out those walls and then... and vacuum out all those dead roaches and all that stuff. Because if you smell it, you can still smell it. It'll linger, dog. A lot of these redone houses in L.A., a lot of them have that where I go over there and I'll spray them all. Yeah, there's a smell that won't go away. I don't really want to tell them unless I'm not to be a dick, because then they're going to fucking rip their walls out. But that's what it's from. Dead rodents, possums, all types of shit.
When I was living in a project as a kid, I remember just chilling with my friend Rafa Moran. Shout out to Raul Vasquez, a listener.
Yeah, man.
I saw Joe. Anyways, I'll get back to that. I remember I was just chilling in the archway, you know, this little place we hang out in. And a fucking one of those cockroaches, a big one passing by.
Water bug.
A fucking roach, a fucking cat creeped up and grabbed that motherfucker.
And ate him?
Yeah. And I was thinking to my friend, said, funny ass comment, he said, well, there ain't no Mises. I don't know, he grabbed it and played with it, but I thought it was nasty, dog.
Yeah.
He caught that motherfucker.
He probably pierced the roach with their fingernail. And it's probably, yeah. he killed all the mice, you know? Now roach, whatever's left, dude. And the little hood cats are strong, fool.
How far are these from eating humans, bro?
Let me tell you, dog.
If you're sleeping, they'll eat you, huh?
No.
If you're dead?
Yeah, but I'm sure, dude, I'm sure it can get that way if there's no food, I'll tell you. If it gets all like, you know, Book of Eli style, you know what I mean? Judgment Day style, who knows?
You think you could be so hungry you could eat roaches?
If I had to survive, I would do it.
Would you eat them alive or you fucking spry them up?
If I had to survive, I would eat them, dog. I'll be like Revenant style, dog.
If you fried them up, would it turn into like lobster texture?
I heard they're good.
It turned into caramel flavor.
Because when I was in Mexico, I ate chapulines, which are like grasshoppers, and they were actually really good.
This frog right here just told me he ate grasshoppers.
Yeah, I did. They were good.
Rodrigo's a bullfrog, people.
I've never eaten them. I've always thought it was gross, but they were sitting there while I was in line to the Frida Kahlo Museum. I have a little video. I'll post it up one day. But yeah, they were actually pretty. They were good. They tasted like little meat, like beef, like salty beef jerky. I know say stop, but I just did it for, you know, the little Anthony Bourdain experience.
Oh man!
But I know it sounds gross.
Scorpions, you can eat them too, right?
Same way they do them, like that. You know, they'll season them or secos. You know, they'll dry them like that, and that's what a little Durango delicacy, right?
Yeah, man, I can't stand no infestation, bro.
And you're like, and I know you're, I know, you know, your palate, and it's not that you're like all like sensitive, but I know certain shit you don't eat. I remember one time we had tamales at my house, and like you took out the olives because I don't like olives in there. I know certain things you're like, oh fuck, you look at something and be like, no, I don't want that.
Hell no, man, I can't have no my tamale with vegetables in it. Come on, mom used to use the same vegetables, bro.
I think they caught the other Mexicans, fool. Or like, you know what I mean?
Or that, or they want to make the fucking tamal bigger, bro. And they put less meat.
Because my mom got that olive in that little piece, a slice of papa from another lady called Doña Josefina back in the day. And I bring it up to her. Like, no, I didn't steal it from her. I was like, come on, you rap just like her, please. But it's all good.
My mom, when we're making tamales, tamale season is coming, right?
Yeah, man.
2 weeks is on. If there are people there that are not family members, Or even if they're family member, but they're not like tied with my mom, that they haven't been around for a while.
Uh-huh.
My mom's right there, bro, walking around, making sure that tamales weigh the same and they look the same. Like she's Pablo Escobar in the
uniforms. Yeah, dude, you have to. You have to keep them like that. Because, you know, and you can tell.
She told my wife, Lisa, están pesados.
It's making them big, dude. You can tell, like, by the end of the last couple batches, fools start to get tired. They're all skinnier. They're bigger. It's like, it's an art to make a good tamale, dude, I think. You know? Not that I know it's easy. Oh, don't worry about it, bro. I can handle it. It's like, it's cool. You can do it. But really good tamales, you have to have, you know, keep doing it. You can fucking be great at it.
I just don't like when people start making tamales and they start adding like nice texture meat and start charging you $10 for it.
No.
Like, what happened, bro? This one is made, bro, with one of the best organic goat meats out there. It's
free range.
Remember when I told that Ivan's mom made those tamales, bro? No, it was the tamales, chile rellenos. With like some almond cream and granada on top.
I've seen them before. I've never.
That's a Mexico thing, right?
Yeah, but I've never eaten them because I don't like that cream. It tastes weird to me.
So yeah, man, we talked to Flacos Tacos, bro. We had a hooked up with Flacos Tacos. They're thinking of bringing a Flacos Tacos to LA.
Fucking bomb ass tacos, by the way, and bomb ass flautas and bomb ass hot.
Yes, people. If you guys like those Flacos Tacos, they're in Berkeley. They're still open. They got one of the best chicken tacos, and they make their own tortillas, and they add jackfruit.
They're bomb.
And yeah, man, he's thinking of opening one up in California, in Boyle Heights or Hollywood area. So we're gonna help him out.
That's awesome, dude.
Help him invest, maybe.
Fuck yeah, dude! And finally bring some quality vegan food to that area too, dude.
Yeah, we're thinking of having I don't know. I wasn't giving him ideas of what he could make, but I always thought it'd be a good idea to, like, if you're gonna move in, like, with your vegan food, especially to Boyle Heights, it's gonna be good. It has to be real good food and authentic. And but you also have to have a meal for people in the neighborhood who can't afford expensive food.
Make
twice.
It affordable.
Yeah, so having like a bowl of fideo with a side of beans and a tortilla.
Yeah, like you would do it at
easy,
home.
Easy, $3.
That's what's up.
$4, whatever. That's a good ass bowl, dog.
Yeah, well, it's funny.
A little mayonnaise on the side.
You gave me a little flashback to when the first time I said, before I met you, I seen you on TV, you had that funny ass joke talking about your dad came up to you. You know how much that plate of food would cost at a restaurant? I've never seen fideo on the menu at a restaurant. That's hilarious.
I've never seen fideo and spam in a menu. I didn't even thought of my special.
No, that was a funny ass joke.
Yeah, because my dad would like, my mom would make good food. You know, we always ate good. You know, we weren't starving. Every once in a while, we ate shit.
Yeah, but whatever.
We ate no steak sandwiches every day.
Right, but shit to keep you full and hearty stuff.
Yeah, man. My dad would look at me and go, you know how much that plate of food would cost in a restaurant? And I'm looking at him going, I don't know, man. I never seen fideo and spam in the same neighborhood.
Hell yeah, dude. So that's awesome, though, dude. Flacos Tacos coming down to the SoCal.
Yes, people. And also, man, if you guys didn't already watch it, I'm on Superstore this Thursday.
Tomorrow. Oh,
tomorrow.
No. Okay. Well, they're going to get
on
Friday,
the 1 hour special.
Fuck yeah, dude. That's awesome, dude, that you're on there twice, shining, dude, and fucking getting close to the holidays. Fucking it.
Shout out to Rebecca Guzman.
Oh, that's right. We've seen her.
Rory Hillman's wife. They showed up deep.
Yeah, man.
To the parlor bar. They gave us a shirt. Rest in peace, Rory Hillman.
Yeah, it was a little bit bittersweet. You know what I mean? I get sad around that shit, but it was nice that they came out. Nice that the
his
family
brother
supported.
Was there. What's his brother's name? Seth.
Seth
Hillman. Shout out if you're listening.
And he was, you know, very, you know, he came up, said what's up, and thank you very much for everything. And they were all very grateful, dog. And it was like, it was cool though that they showed up and represented. And it's like, cause dude, you guys don't let a lot of people in, you know, the circle. And not that that's what it's for, but. Rory was a lot of people come up to us, you know, with try this or that, bomb ass bud, and you know, a lot of people. And I'm trying to be a dick or nothing, but.
And then they kill the mood by saying they want to be comedians.
Yeah, that or they just linger on too much.
Trying to interview you.
He wasn't like that, dude, and he had little dab, like bomb like shit, and so that was cool, good energy, dude, and like, you know, when humans come around like that, it's fucking awesome, and it was cool to see it all fucking go down again. You know, it sucks that he's gone. Rest in peace, but it was nice to see everybody and everybody into it and liking how they did the little tribute to him on this show, and it was cool, man. It was nice to see them.
Sold out some shows over there.
Oh, fuck yeah. It was fucking
deep.
Packed, dude.
Oh,
yeah.
My God, dude. The last show at the Parlor Bar in Bellevue was crazy. As soon as I went up on stage, these guys pulled up a big Mexican flag with a Raider logo on it.
They're hardcore.
Hardcore Raider fans.
I was like, damn. Yeah, dude, I was like, fucking dude. Like,
the security guard has to tell him, I mean, you got to put that flag down, man. People trying to watch the show.
How you always say? Representing, dog.
Representing,
to
huh?
To the core.
Happy we're 7-2.
Yes, dude. It's been a long time coming. Remember that one time, that Super Bowl, when the fuck, what was it, the fucking center took off to TJ and fucked up the whole game?
And Martin got all loaded.
We've been waiting since then, dog. 2000 or 2001?
How long has that been?
Dude, like fucking 14 years, maybe 13 years. Easy, easily.
Had it been that long?
Remember we went to Big Dog's house and fucking Larry was there. You came for a little while. I'm not fucking, I'm going to leave. Eh? I was like, damn, all right, dog. And fucking, yeah, Martin got all loaded. Didn't he punch the wall or something?
Yeah, he punched the wall. Martin Moreno and G. Riley were loaded, bro. They couldn't drive, and Willie got a hotel for them at the Holiday Inn right there on Silver Lake.
Yeah, dude.
And then it's funny, man, Martin wouldn't shut up over the loss. And he told the guy at the front desk when Willie was ordering the room for them, fuck you, are you a fucking Raider fan, puto? Hey, man, I'm just trying to check you into your room, sir. But are you a Raider fan, homie?
Relax.
I'm just trying to get you a room for the night, sir. But are you a Raider fan?
And it's funny you brought up Benny earlier. We talked about, like, remember Martin used to do comedy in a Raiders poncho?
Oh, he was shout out to MC Pancho from Wilmington.
Yeah, dog. So yeah, man, it's been a long time coming.
Anybody know that dude on Instagram? His name is MC Pancho. Tell him we say what's up. Just say the What's Up Fool podcast appreciates all his funny ass photos.
Yeah, man.
It's funny, man. MC Pancho, he's just a regular fool dog from Harbor Aria, right? He has a fucking crazy mustache. And his wife, I think it's Japanese, Chamorrita.
Uh-huh.
And that guy's just a working man, bro. Crazy.
Keeping it 100, dog.
His face tattooed.
Yeah, dude.
Is he the same? No, he's not, huh? When I first saw that guy, MC Pancho, with his face tattooed, mm-hmm. I thought he was the same guy that has all the Raider logos on his face.
No, I don't think. No, that's not the same dude.
That guy's crazy, huh?
Oh, hell yeah. This other dude has more like little tribal stuff and, you know, little cool little things, but no, not all the way.
You think you're going to get a lot of tattoo when you turn 40, bro, and buy a Harley?
I don't know about all that.
Just hang out with Dean Del Rey, bro, and stare at guitars and jerk off.
Let there be no more talk, bro.
That fool got small, bro.
He looks like, I mean, I ain't trying to bag on him. I always say stuff to him like, what's going on? In a Joe Diaz voice, what's going on, Dean Del Rey? Oh, yeah, what's going on, guy? Yeah. But he always reminded me of the grandpa on ding 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 ding.
Cotton.
Yeah, what's up? What's up? King of the Hill, dude. I'm slipping.
More like Bobby Hill.
I thought it was Cotton, but yeah, it's all. But he does look all shrunk. I think he's losing weight though. That's why.
Let's stop eating sugar. A lot of weight.
No sugar whatsoever.
But his thing was candy. Who eats that much candy, dude?
Keith. Damn, I didn't know that. Wow. Okay. Gotta cut back on my sugar. Wow, man. But, and I think once you're older too, you lose body mass when you lose a lot of weight, you know what I mean? So you gotta, you know, keep a happy medium.
I like soda still.
Soda's good, dude.
And cakes.
I had a Diet Coke over the weekend. That was cool.
Had a Mexican Coke the other day. It was delicious.
Yeah, dog. That's what I had, the Fanta one.
Today I'm gonna eat Chinese food at Hot Wu with water.
Shit. Okay.
I'm gonna go to Hot Wu, people. Hot Wu on Broadway. Man, they got the best. Noodles, bro. Like, they make these noodles that I love. First of all, they put the noodles in vegetable oil and they deep fry them, bro. So when you get the noodles on the plate, they're already hard. Plus, they have this veggie broth with vegetables and that Chinese broccoli and carrots. And it's so hot, like molten lava.
It's got a...
and bok choy. And you put it, they put it over those fried noodles that you just fried.
Softens
and it
them.
Just softens everything, bro. And it just tastes a little
that's
crispy.
What's up,
it, it tastes like a delicious goo of deliciousness. And also, I also order these spicy eggplants, bro, with a bunch of teriyaki, bro. Of course, it's vegan, no meat in it.
Sounds good,
and
though,
I mix
dude.
It all up sometimes with a little bit of white rice or I put in my soup.
Bomb.
And then Isaac Hayes. Miklo.
Is that the lobster?
He gets the lobster for $9.99.
Right, so that's right there in Chinatown.
Yeah.
Then. Oh, we passed by there. You pointed it out a couple times. That's awesome, dude.
Yeah, man.
Sounds good. I don't know. I want to try the noodles, dude.
We have a podcast listener who lives in that area now. He's an artist.
Dan Gibson.
He's an artist in that Chinatown area.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty good to hang out there, bro. I mean, if you ever decide to go on an escapade or do shrooms or... disappear or a place to go hang out, Chinatown's the spot.
Yeah, I never really hung out too much. Just when we go to the Wongkok a little bit and stuff like that. But yeah, dude, it looks fucking cool there.
Wongkok's good too.
Fuck yeah, dude. It's bomb, dude. But I want to try that place with the noodles.
You gotta go, man. Let's go. What they call Szechuan noodles?
No, it's crispy chow mein.
Crispy chow mein.
Damn, that sounds bomb.
Man, China is so big. As Mexico is so big, you know, America is big, but you pretty much you get a pizza, you're gonna taste the same fucking pizza anywhere you go. A hamburgers, I don't care if McDonald's makes it or Bobby Flay makes it. Hey, it's just a hamburger. It's always gonna taste the same. But China, man, is different because there's so many provinces and regions.
Yeah, those provinces, dude.
That the Chinatown here in downtown LA is different from the Chinatown in Boston, because over here we're part of the Ming Dynasty. And then there was a Szechuan. It's totally different.
Yeah, that in different regions. Some people capitalize more on pork, some on chicken. What's in their little territories and areas, dude. You know what I mean? And then noodles.
Like Mexico too, man. They don't even got burritos over there.
No, burritos are American, just like nachos, dude. But, I mean, dude, the moles goes from Sonora all the way down. It changes, dude. And, I mean, look at, like, the coastal parts where, like, Sinaloa and Nayarit, where your folks are from. All that stuff. I mean, the mariscos are different. I mean, dude, there's no mariscos in Zacatecas. There's no rivers. There's no ocean. Come on, fool.
They're eating beavers.
Or are they what they call the cactus pear, like shrimps?
Man, this girl wrote a blog.
Oh, the mole one?
About how horrible mole is. She doesn't have good mole.
First of all, somebody in her house doesn't know how to cook good mole, bottom line.
Man, Mando's wife, she makes her mole watery.
Yeah, her mole is way different. I've only...
Her mole is more Chinese style, bro. Very watery.
Yeah, and it could...
like curry style.
It could probably come right there from a little Chihuahua area. Yeah. You know what I mean? But, I mean, I've tasted several different kind of moles.
I like my mole to be thick, bro.
Yeah, I like it thick. I like my mole...
to be flavorful.
No skin and to shred the chicken. You know what I mean? Sometimes some people put it in there with that little elbow. Bone. Yeah, I don't like it, dog. It's cool, but why would I want to suck on a bone like that, dog? It's like, ugh.
I'm down for like black mole, like the real mole. There's like four types, right? There's mole, pipián,
and there's that the chocolate one, right?
Yeah.
I don't know what that's called.
That's probably mole, no?
Yeah, cause
the chipotle. At least I got one the other day.
There's most of it has chocolate in it.
The one you had, what did they say on the bottom? It didn't say mole.
The Oaxaqueña one, I think.
And that's probably a darker one that comes from the southern part, right there, Oaxaca, Quintana Roo, Yucatan, all that stuff. Right.
My mom used to make that shit herself. The mole. Yeah.
Mama, like,
the red one.
Yeah, like, dude, my mom makes it from scratch, dude. And she tried to make that little chocolate one before with that abuelita chocolate. It's all right, but she was just trying it out because, you know, fucking same mole for the fucking past 13 years. Let's try to diversify the portfolio over here.
Make it a mouth watery, dude.
But they put cacao in it.
Cacao.
But not regular bar chocolate or whatever. I think that was maybe a little milk chocolate. Maybe.
It was that hard chocolate? Yeah. They put that little brick in there and they let it smolder. But it's all different. And then isn't there like green mole too, right?
Pipián, the pumpkin seed one, it's no chocolate in it.
Pipián's the one that my grandfather used to make, and he would just get it out of the jar and mix it there and make it just for me when I was there with him.
Hey, what is that? What is that street right there on Hollywood Boulevard where the Fat Burger is? And then
on
there's
Hollywood.
Yeah, and it goes all the way. No, it's in Hollywood, and it goes all that street will take you all the way to Griffith Park. It's Vermont, huh? Vermont,
yeah,
by the Fat Burger right there by Hollywood on Sunset.
Yeah, I want to say yes, dude. I mean, obviously.
Well, right there, bro, is where the Hollywood the bus splits and goes to Sunset or it goes to Hollywood Boulevard.
Okay.
And then there's a little Mexican restaurant across the street from the Starbucks,
Yuca?
Los Feliz. Not Yuca. I don't know the name of it. But right there, fool, I walked in there because I was hungry and I wanted a taco and a burrito. Uh-huh. Fool, right there, they had a mole burrito.
I've eaten one.
Fucked that shit up, bro. It was good.
It has an orange sign. It's like tacos. It has
been there
eagle.
Forever.
Yeah, we've eaten there before.
Yeah, it's a car wash.
Exactly. They have those that old gate that's painted with yellow thick paint.
Yeah, just the hot sauce is not game.
No,
on
point, no,
bro.
No, no.
And they got some jalapenos there that need more vinegar, bro. they're stewed, dog.
Yeah, they haven't been. I don't know. They're doing hot water to pickle them faster.
But that place been in business, bro, because they just keep it to the same menu, man. We've been in cheese burritos, mole burrito. Yeah. But a lot of those places that are like that aren't the best for Al Pastor.
No. Their little stuff is probably like the mole burrito and all that, like, you know, regular stuff.
Some good stuff, man.
Yeah, man.
What's up, fool? Election day. President Donald J. Trump.
Elect.
Elect.
Yeah, man.
So he's going to make it, huh? 4 years.
Yeah, dude. We'll see what happens.
I hope we only have one season of Donald Trump, bro. Just one season, and that's it.
Let's see what he does, dude. You know what I mean? Hey, that's what the electors
wanted.
But
the next person that comes trying to make him down, kind of come strong, bro.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. Well, it's going to be interesting to watch.
Are the Bush going
to
bring in somebody?
Well, I know they're like, look at the nephew, right? Jeb's son. He's a land commissioner in Texas right now with George P. Bush.
His name is Prescott Bush Jr.
They're named after his grandfather.
And he's just as dark as me, so he got to be cool.
Speaks Spanish. He's
like a novella actor, bro.
Yeah, dude.
I don't know why he didn't come out, bro. They must be preserving him for later. Huh?
I think they're just still, you know, they're molding him in the little thing. Texas land commissioner is a big
little
fucking
Bush Mexican in the cupboard.
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
exactly.
Man. I guess Joe Lopez, if he don't moves to Canada, he should just not do a meet and greet in places that voted for Trump.
We'll see. That's going to be interesting to see what that turns into. But it was funny how, dude, like, she had every celebrity in her corner, huh, fool, and it didn't happen, dog. People didn't want that shit anymore, dog. Trippy, fool.
We like Jay-Z, but we don't like you.
He crazy, huh? Beyonce was there with her, dog. Katy Perry, all these fools, dog. Nothing.
Nothing, bro. You needed a what's the name, bro? Doug Christie.
Well, Chris Christie. Like, that fool's. I don't know. I think he's going to be in his cabinet.
He's sidling right there, huh?
Oh, fool, that. Because, you know, shit.
Rudy Giuliani?
Oh, my God. That fool's going to start flapping his jaws like you never believed, dog.
All these other people saying that they're behind Rush Limbaugh.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't he going up against them and stuff? All these dudes, right? Like, Hannity was on his team. The one that talked a lot of crap about him was Glenn Beck.
Yeah, he wasn't.
Yeah, he was, like, very disastrous towards him. And it's funny, though, now, because remember the Republicans were distancing from him? Paul Ryan and all that shit after that Grab the Pussy little audio came out. So I wonder how those fools are going to act to the commander-in-chief now. Very interesting, man. A lot of history there, man.
The funniest tweet I saw was some white lady. She tweeted, "We're watching the last season of America." That shit had 860. Like, what the? How is that? I mean, if you have money in the bank saved up right now, if you're here legally, if you fucking obey all the laws, nothing's gonna happen to you.
It's illegal for them to mess with you in any way.
If you obey when the cops say stay down and you stay down, you're gonna be fine.
Don't go out there and start protesting, throwing rocks, because they're gonna beat you up. The cops.
But I tell you, this is gonna give people a lot of jobs, though. Like people who are in the comedy, who are against Trump, like D.L. Hewley. He might have his own show on CNN. Did you hear him this morning?
No, but I know he was mentioning stuff in a couple interviews before because he's been getting all political. It's kind of funny, like, people have been talking shit. What do you got to get all political and shit?
He was trending on Twitter.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Yeah,
that's
for
good
him.
For him.
Hell yeah.
I'm not even trending right now. What's up, fool? Okay, man, this week we're going to be at the Addison Improv, Rodrigo Torres. Us,
yeah, man.
We're going to be at the Addison Improv all week, Thursday through Sunday. Also, ma'am, we're going to be hanging out at Spiral Diner with Renee Floyd.
Hell yeah, dude. They have that good salad place right there, too, though, huh?
That's next to the club, though.
Yeah. And that's in Dallas, though.
Yeah, I'm going to tear up them nachos, bro.
They're good, dog. They're good.
Get a lot of food home.
Hell yeah, dude.
What's up, fool? God bless America. Stay strong.
Yeah, man.
Stay together, man. Don't hate the person over there because he likes Trump. Don't hate the person because she likes Hillary. Let's just all hold hands because we're in it to win it, bro.
Yeah, man. What are you going to do? Just be a nice person, fool.
And also, man, you want to make America great? Volunteer, bro. Volunteer, man. Do your social service to our country by helping an old man walk the street. Volunteer at the hospital. Donate your time, man. If you're a struggling actor, a struggling painter, and you see that the cutting art programs, volunteer your time. You teach them for free, motherfucker. Stop depending on the government to pay you to teach them when you can just teach them for free. All right, man. I'm out. Felipe Esparza, Rodrigo Torres.
Yeah, man.
What's up, fool?
Peace. Awesome, fool.
Yeah, man.